You ever gonna start smoking weed?
When I turned 26, 27, I went back to joints and I stopped smoking the blunts.
You ever gonna start smoking weed?
Probably, actually sooner, probably like 25.
I think no answer is an answer.
I'd say you ever gonna start smoking weed? Like, just like out of your, just like, fuck it, I'm like too old type shit. Like 90, I don't want to. You still gonna be fucking puffing that old dog? All right, touche. Because at some point, there has to be one of the artists that they're going to tell, hey, fool, like, you're going to be the first one that doctors told you to stop.
No, that's not going to ever be me, son.
I'm not, you know, you're pretty healthy, but I'm saying, like, I'm pretty sure, like, Tommy Chong had to stop.
No, the doctor's going to be like, hey, homie, we need your lung because you beat something with all
this. we need to fucking investigate what you're made of.
Yeah. Tommy, he got cancer when he went to prison. He couldn't smoke, right? Then he came back out, smoked, and it's gone.
He got it from the prison food.
Yeah.
Willie Nelson still smoking.
Yeah, man.
Okay, but how old are those guys, though? Tommy Chong's like what? Like
80s.
Yeah.
Tommy Chong stopped? No, he's still smoking.
I think Cheech is the one that stopped.
Nah, they both smoke.
He just doesn't. Look, the thing is that Cheech and Chong don't like smoke fucking heavy like that. They smoke, but it's not crazy heavy.
They smoke like a Joey Diaz would.
They never blazed like it was a competition like motherfuckers do today. Like, oh, I blazed more than you.
I've got a fire extinguisher.
People try to take my head off for that shit. I'm like, okay.
Do people come at you like because you're like considered the king?
Sometimes it'd be like, don't cut your own head off, dog. You know what I'm saying?
I seen Avery Spears like, please open the window, dog.
Gotta push it.
Not gonna record hooking me up with weed. Thank you, Izzo.
Fuck you, bitch. That's my stash.
What up, y'all? I know I might have skipped a few days, but it is now Wednesday. It is probably 2 days before I take off to Tokyo, Japan for the second year in a row. I just finished the We Don't Smoke the Same podcast. We were gonna try to do it all the way to Thursday, and I was gonna have this big Nas extravaganza, but it didn't work out that way because I wanna be at the airport on time and I don't wanna miss my flight that I paid a lot of money for. Nonetheless, man, I finally started packing. I finally started doing all my packing. I finally started getting stuff done one-on-one. And the actual thoughts started to all settle in, man. Like, I'm starting to think, fuck, man, I'm gonna miss my cats. I'm gonna miss a lot of the weed here. I'm gonna miss all this stuff. But I'm also get excited about all the new stuff I'm gonna discover while I'm out there. But thank you, everybody who's been watching the We Don't Smoke the Same podcast. I hope you enjoy the shows while I'm gone. What up, y'all? Good morning. Now, sorry about the last couple day updates. I really didn't keep you guys updated because I did not prepare on how long it was gonna take for me to get ready to prepare. You know what I'm saying? Like, to get everything ready. I'm over here smoking this last joint before we head on to the airport. I'm a little bit excited, you know what I'm saying? I'm a little bit excited, a little bit nervous. I'm excited for all the stuff that I'm about to check out that's new. You know what I'm saying? This is my saddest part about leaving whenever I go on trips, is leaving my pets. It's my oldest dog, Ozzy. He's already like 14. Like my son, Bombastic. Where's he at? It's actually quite sad to leave this fellow right here. It's my friend Harvey right here. Bye, Harvey. Bye. It's my little feral cat eating his little fish. Look at them sharp ass nails. Man, I'm gonna miss like just working every day with this motherfucker. He's my little companion. And sad to leave this little guy too. This is my little friend, Meow. Come on, man. You got a little handshake, man. Fucking asshole. I took a fucking RSO this morning, 1,000 milligrams. We'll see how that fucking goes. Without eating at all.
Opening them up.
What up, YouTube?
Checking in from the Paul Harris Lounge here at the United Airlines. No, I'm not gonna lie. This shit's kind of mids over here, bro. Like, this shit's kind of mids. And that's maybe because I was used to the Singapore airline one. I don't know if you guys know, but Singapore is kind of like the most bougie airline you can get next to Emirates. Emirates is probably like the top one.
This is the United Club, I think.
It's United Club.
But you're spoiled with Singapore.
Okay, yeah, exactly. So as my, like my girlfriend's saying, like, if you ever fly Singapore Airlines, you'll know the difference, bro. It's worth the money, I'll tell you that much. But yeah, this is the day of, all the way down. From you guys seeing all the vlogs, this is the day of me taking off. As you can see, I'm over here a few cocktails in. Give me a little bit of apple juice that I spilled on the table on accident. So I'm not gonna lie. Everybody that's watching this, I took a Cali Blaze SHO pre-flight. That shit is kicking my ass, y'all. Like, I mean, it's probably about to be the most epic game of Pokemon I probably played on the airplane ever. So I'm not gonna lie, I'm kind of happy about that. But I kind of wish that this lounge would have been the same lounge I was at last year. Look at this. This is fucking whiskey, bro. She poured a heavy ass hand. She didn't want to see my face back at the fucking bar. She was like, yo, te la verga.
No, but the staff here is
damn, nice. That should go take off. Wait.
Parece que fuera las aerolíneas mexicanas.
That's how fast my penis was. We got my exchange going on. I'm not gonna lie. I think they got nicer money than us. Like, I honestly think they have nicer money. Like, they've been had that little shiny shit before us. I wonder what color it burns.
It burns?
Yeah, because you know, when you burn like a US dollar, like it's like a certain color, that's why they're able to tell if it's fake or not, or something like that. Like in big with big amounts. I don't know.
He's like, man, we supposed to be working, man. On 5-5 crib, man. Man, we seen them two cuss their ass fools. Man, free crib Mac though, for real though, man.
All right, what's up everybody? I just got to the hotel room. Man, after a legit 12-hour flight, I didn't really sleep in there as much. I kind of did because I stayed up all night last night. I was up till like 1 just trying to take care of a lot of things before I left. And I still didn't take care of all the things besides your guys' packages. So, you know what I'm saying? The other thing though, man, I'll tell you this right off the bat. I like flying first class and business class, but I'm probably not going to fly with United again. If you're gonna fly fucking first class international, bro, just stick to Emirates or some of the higher end if you're gonna go for like a leisure experience. Cause you're gonna, the more you spend, the more bang you're gonna get for your buck, bro. I was in business class for fucking United. That shit was like congested, bro. Like, I'm just like, man, I'm feeling like a little cartoncito. Not even like the Emirates one, which is like an Asian airline. They should have bigger space, bro, but it is what it is. The food, kind of fucking mids on the plane, bro. United Airlines, step your shit up, bro. People in first class don't like to eat some old-ass fucking ribs. You know what I mean? That, like, just, like, they don't give you much options. It was just kind of whack, bro. I was just like, hey, bro, I don't want to eat this fucking egg cake. You know what I mean? Like, they were just like, well, that's all we got. I was kind of over it, bro. All right, but nonetheless, though, so getting to the hotel room. Hotel room... It's pretty cool, bro. It's kind of a little bit on the smaller side. We might upgrade the suite just because, I don't know. It looks a little bit like too on the smaller side. You know, I don't know, at least for me, at least for us. Like, because I know I'm going to be buying a bunch of shit. I'm just used to a little bit more space. You know what I'm saying? But the hotel's nice. It's kind of like right around the corner from where I stayed at last year.
which is the Condrado Hotel. It's a pretty nice view of the city and the bridge coming in. You know what I'm saying? But overall, it's the first night in Japan. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to knock down a high and hungry just yet, but I'm pretty fucking hungry, though. I'll tell you that much. I'm pretty fucking hungry. I guess this would consider as high and hungry because I took the RSO. Not to mention. So peep this, y'all. And yes, that noise that you're hearing is SpongeBob in Japanese. That's Japanese SpongeBob going down. That fool sounds all weird. But check it out. 4 SHOs. That's what I'm talking about, man. 4 SHOs. Don't ask how. Don't ask when. Just know. We on. We on. Or at least I am. Look at this shit. Fools out here fucking eating and shit. Nice little dining board. I'm sorry, nice little dining table. I don't think I have a good shot. I gotta do it without the reflectiveness. Let's see what this person's doing. The fuck? Did he just vanish into the wall? Alright. Badass fucking bridge. No congestion. Nobody's tripping the fucking copper. But yeah, this is Tokyo from the hotel room. Probably gonna hit the streets right now in a little bit. Get something to eat, bro. I'm fucking starving. Can't blaze it, but I don't know yet. We'll see. Look at that TV over here. I don't know, some fucking... This is like... Now this is where I'm watching SpongeBob and shit. That shit just don't translate to America. That shit looks like Pee-wee's Playhouse. The fuck? Finally out of that hotel room. Gonna go check out this dope building I saw on the way over here. It's actually quite the most interesting building right outside the hotel room. And if it's a bar, I'm probably stopping in there for a drink. What the fuck is that? It's actually pretty fucking interesting. Look at the details on this shit. I wonder if it actually moves. That's like steampunk style. Look at the inside though. Is this where they make the future badios and they make you shit or what? That's the current time. It's about to be 7 p.m. over here. The architecture on this looks fucking crazy. It almost looks like that house in Casper. It's pretty fucking dope. Dope ass building. Look at that cat shaped bread. That is like the cutest shit ever, yo. If I could have a catfish, I mean, I'm sorry, a cat-shaped sandwich, that would just be it. Look, they have more stuff here, too. Look, they have little paws. And they have, like, a little black cat treats. Yeah. Oh, it smells like that place where I threw up.
That place that we ate in the corner?
Yeah. Right here.
Oh, that's right.
That is the spot, ladies and gentlemen. It's not to knock anything against this spot, but like I was sick as a dog when I ate here. And I literally stopped by and got some food inside there, and I threw that shit right up. Like, the noodles were still intact. Everything was still cool. Currently in the city of Shinbashi right now. Probably gonna go grab some grub at the ramen spot we left last time. I wonder if they have beer at that ramen spot. And there it is. This is the new Sakura drink. I have not had that one. This is different from last year, for sure. Yeah, I'm reviewing both of those. And I'm taking some of those cups. But then again, I don't doubt it because they keep their city clean. They'll scrape your shit right off, as they did to mine. Sounds of Japan. I think I put it on one of these machines, no? It's not on the machine for sure, it's not. It's gone. Oh, maybe right here? Nah. Look at that, Minato smoking space. You wanna smoke cigarettes? That's where you go. Hot box cigarettes inside there. Fool, thank God for SHO, man. Look at that train right in the middle of the city. I said that train.
Yeah, I remember that train.
Oh, there's our fucking spot. Oh my God, it's closed.
Oh, you're right.
Are you serious? So this is the spot we came to last year. It's literally right on Shinbashi. That's kind of like what I go for right here. Or that one. I do get two refills. Now we gotta find somewhere else to eat, or maybe a bar. KFC. That's where Stefton would go. Let's go.
He's been here, right?
Yeah.
He likes it?
He said he would come back, but it's the getting on the plane part.
Oh my God, is
that? Yeah, I'm finna hit this KFC later on. Damn, he looking like fucking, he was stuck between me and a guy and a fucking tough lady. Fucking retarded. Yeah, this shit looks good. What is this right here? It's like cook it yourself? Nah. Let me see. Nah. Yeah?
Yes.
What about right here? Look at that. That's what you've been drinking at the studio, and that's what I'm about to drink in Japan. You guys have Hayate too?
Sorry?
Do you have Hayate?
Hayate.
The whiskey? Hayate whiskey? You have that?
Hayate.
Yeah. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but I tried it last time. It was pretty good. Yeah, okay.
That's Japanese.
Yeah, it's Japanese. Oh, okay, okay. No worries. Oh, you guys are real Irish folk. Look at this. First drink out here in Japan. Cheers. Not bad. I've been drinking that shit at the airplane the whole time. It's a pretty packed scene over here at this bar. Like, you got a lot of people in the back just kicking it. The bartenders are cool as hell. All right, there's a 30. Pour me one, dog. Come on. If Shaw has to open it and let me know that there's a 30 one, let me get one on the rocks, please.
Let's see it. We'll be basking its glory, I guess.
You know, once upon a time, somebody had a really great time with that bottle here. Check this out. We got this Japanese fried chicken at Irish Pub out here. Look at this. I mean, it's not like the one that we had on the street last time, but you only really know based on texture, bro. That's really why you only really know. It's based on texture and the crispiness of this motherfucker. God damn. That's like pretty good. For bar food, it'll do, man. Nice little high, drunk, and hungry up in here. Real quick one. With the homie all the way from Denmark.
All the way.
Is that farther than where I came from? I came from LA.
I think, yeah.
That's yeah. How long was your plan? Like 12 hours.
Yeah, this is also quite a change for me. I'm, Denmark's literally quite small, but I'm from a countryside town.
Yeah?
With 2,000 people, and I live outside.
Like farm and shit?
Yeah, kind of. I mean, we don't do farming, but we have horses and chickens.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a very nice country, but it's quite boring, like, nature-wise.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel you.
It's very flat.
It's cold, right?
I like to say that Denmark has like the middle of fall.
It's not bad. But a lot more fun here?
Sorry?
A lot more fun for you here?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Not bad. So much more to do.
I just never like, you know, you go to a place and you're like, fuck, people value nature. You know what I mean? Like, you're just like, holy shit. Like,
yeah, even then, Denmark's nature is, like, there's a, like, 60% of Denmark is just farmland.
Damn.
60%.
That sounds like Wisconsin. Shit. Yeah.
It sounds like Wisconsin.
Yeah,
it's a, pretty much like, yeah.
Damn. Well, glad you're out here. Glad we met.
Yeah, I'm happy to be here, for sure.
Yeah.
It's an experience, unlike Denmark, which is monotone.
Yeah, I was telling her, I'm like, I came here the first time, right? And then I come back and my algorithm starts showing me like you can buy real estate out here. So I'm just like, bro, like they just keep throwing me little things and I'm just like, all right, bro, 25 grand for 40 grand for a house. It seems, I can't even get a house in America, bro. Like,
nobody in America.
Yeah, bro, like it's
nothing less than a million.
Bro, your whole family could sell their souls and they still would be like, yo.
Maybe like four generations.
Yeah, they could be like, hey, you're still gonna pay 9 grand a month. Like, bro, are you serious? Like, come on. For a house that's like maybe like two of these bars. And I'm like, come on, bro. Like my dog can't even run, you know?
That is big in Japan standards, though.
Yeah.
You're not getting a lot of square feet here for dollars.
Yeah. That is true. When we drove by the apartments, we're just like, what the hell, bro?
Yeah.
That's why all the houses for sale that are big houses, they're like at least a good hour away.
Yeah.
Those
are the only cheap bigger houses.
Yeah.
If you want to get cheap big houses, you gotta go to the countryside.
Yeah, that's what.
Very cheap.
And you gotta like renovate it too, bro. Yeah.
They usually break down houses after like 30 or 40 years.
Yeah, those are a lot of the houses. Dude, a lot of them look modern, bro. I'm just like, bro, if I bring my own team of like Mexicans with me and then fucking fix it, I think I'd be able to do it.
We could do a whole real estate.
Yeah. We could start my own landscaping company out here and be like, yo.
Right, so we left the Irish pub and now we walked into this little steakhouse in here. But look at the price on this steak.
This,
yep. This is like $5 for a steak, yo. Well, for one of them. I like that you get all these butters from them. I like the music choice they have here. Look at that ribeye steak, bro. The little sauces everywhere. So this restaurant is like hella small. But it's pretty cool though. It's like very cozy. You get in, you get out.
I want to say at least these type of steak places, you'll find them like everywhere. Like at least all the little touristy areas. But they're good value for your buck, bro. And not to mention, this isn't a normal kind of beer that I would usually drink. I would usually like a little bit something heavier. But it is what it is. We already know that craft beer is probably a lot harder to find out here. I mean, we'll see about that. Cheers, y'all.
All right, y'all, so checking in, $20, bro. $20 for both meals. plus the beer. You get the rice, you get the little soup, you get the corn. Look at this. Dump the little fucking butter on top. Bro, what else do you want, bro? What else do you want? I mean, goddamn. For $20 fucking, bro. Y'all tripping. $20.
This is technically high hungry in Japan. Of course, you gotta start off with the soup. That's what 1996 fucking Asian food tasted like. Like authentic, before all the people got tired of living in America. Alright, so check it out, bro. This is what you call, I mean, technically this would be like a $10 steak. This is Vegas prices, y'all. This is Vegas 2 a.m. prices right here. I thought that Vegas was the only place that you could get a steak for this fucking of a deal. But check this out. Oh, check this out. I'm sorry, it was a lot of meat. Pause. This is just a big piece of carne asada served to you in a plate with arroz con sopa for just $20. The one crazy thing about it though that I do want to say that I like that they offer here a little bit more is the options when it comes to dipping your steak. Look at that. They give you cheese, bro, as an option. Cheese. And in case you haven't tried though, like that is truly like a big good munchy combination. The cheese on top of the steak. I never seen this at any American steakhouse, if I have to be honest. Like, I haven't seen the cheese going on the steak in any American house. I actually had to do that at Fogo de Chao, and I actually put Be Real on to put in blue cheese on top of his steak. But look, not for nothing. And I know, out of place, the most out of place fucking hash brown ever. And just on the first night over here, of course, coming down off the RSO, coming down off the SHO, coming down off all the cups of whiskey. Honestly, if you ever see any of these little small steak places, that when you come out here, if you do come out here, take a little walk inside. Find a little chair. Trust me, it's going to be, you got $20 in your pocket. You got $20 in your pocket, you got steak ready to eat here in Japan. I don't know what the deal is with the hash brown though. Definitely truly fire though.
Yeah, we should, right?
I didn't know this was like an official parking spot. That's crazy, like, cause you rarely see like parking spots here, huh?
Yeah, you actually rarely see them. But these are it, right?
Yeah. You should hit up like a Lawson's or something. That girl too is been fucking.
You see how she's standing like she's cold?
Yeah, like shit ain't worth it.
So más que trabaja, no?
Huh?
Son más que trabaja.
Yeah, I think so. Or they? Yeah. I don't think they're hookers though.
No. Las que trabajan así de que te dan servicio como te traen comida. Damn, it's fucking cold, baby.
Fuck yeah. That's what feels good when I get back home. Me, so.
Spicy.
I'm gonna get your gorilla meat. Gorilla sandwiches in Japan. We finally made it to the store here, man. That had the best selection of whiskey last time. For to get me some cigarettes, some whiskey.
Huh?
Roto.
Damn, they don't have a Hayate this time. Fuck. I guess I gotta get this Nika. Yeah. There it is. Okay. You know, this is the last one too. There it is. The last one. I literally could not find this anywhere else. Hayate. Hayate. We're gonna see what this one does. Since we're gonna go to sleep early already. I mean, it's gonna rain tomorrow though. Oh, these are fire. Fuck that. These are fucking fire. This shit right here, though, this Tropicana Essentials Mango Blend, that shit be smacking, bro. What the hell, where are these at? What? Shinbashi Classic Lager. That's crazy. I find a nice little brewery here. I'm gonna stop by here tomorrow. Craft beer.